Tonight, we're getting you all set for the festive season. And here's my first hack. Have a stash of batteries for Christmas Day, because no one wants to see sad little faces when they're not included with their toys.
I can see it now. And because we're all about cost saving, I've put a range of them to the test to see which brands will give you the best bang for your buck.
A toy's work is never done. Endlessly entertaining kids until they lose attention, or Thomas here runs out of steam.
It takes two AAAs to get this engine working again. Simple, right? But what type of AAA and which brand will keep it running the longest?
We've got two tests lined up to find out, because we won't get far going off the labels, which promise to be anything from super, super heavy duty, extra heavy duty, long lasting, long life, super life, ultra, intense, max, and just when you thought you couldn't top that, max plus advanced.
Sounds like toothpaste. So forget all that. What you want to find out is what the battery is made from.
There are three main types of disposable batteries. Alkaline. It's become the affordable go-to battery for everyday items like toys, basic torches, wireless mouse and keyboards, and baby monitors. Carbon zinc. These are for things that don't need a lot of power, including clocks, calculators, and radios. And then there's lithium iron disulfide, which delivers a constant high voltage, which is great for cameras, shavers, and video game controllers. But they're 2 to 3 times more expensive.
Some of the packaging has clues. For example, EverReady has a picture of a remote control, a toy, and a mouse on its alkaline pack. But you won't find a toy on its carbon zinc one. It has a clock, remote, and torch instead.
So with that in mind, we're going with alkaline batteries for our first test. We've chosen four brands that range in price. A four-pack of Panasonic Alkaline AAAs cost $10.50. Energizer Max was $10. EverReady Gold, $7. And Philips Alkaline was by far the cheapest, $2.25. A number of brands also have premium options, but we're going for the ones you can easily find in store. With that, we start our engines. To begin with, the Philips and Panasonic powertrains raced around their tracks. We recorded lap times every hour, and for the first couple, they were nearly a second faster than the others. But by the fifth hour, Philips seemed to be burning out, like EverReady, which started off doing laps at 8 seconds before slowing down to 11 seconds. They weren't the only ones needing to pace themselves. Finally, after listening to wheels churning for 10 hours and 5 minutes, we had our first breakdown.
Oh, come on, Philips. You can do it, you can do it.
But the little engine could not. 36 minutes later, EverReady gave up the ghost. But the other two kept chugging on for another 3 hours. The lap time is getting considerably slower. Then Panasonic clocked out at 13 hours and 34 minutes, while Energizer Max pushed on for one more minute. We'll get to what that means for your wallet, but first, we got a battery specialist to help us understand our unscientifically controlled test.
So there's always going to be slight differences between manufacturers and their levels of performance.
Which is why we saw the trains run at different speeds, despite all being alkaline.
It'll all come down to their internal electrochemistry, right? And the manufacturer's specific recipe.
We also wanted to compare the performance of the alkaline batteries to the other two types we mentioned earlier, given that carbon zinc or heavy-duty batteries aren't suited for power-hungry toys. How would they go? And on the flip side, how much longer could a lithium battery keep them going for? So, we bought a pack of Panasonic's Extra Heavy Duty for $4.40, EverReady's Super Heavy Duty for $6, Energizer's Ultimate Lithium cost a mega $29.50, and it sure wasted no time running circles around the two carbon zincs. EverReady's Super Heavy Duty train failed after just 5 hours and 4 minutes. Panasonic's Extra Heavy Duty struggled on for another 12 minutes. But it was the so-called longest-lasting battery in the world that had us surprised, Energizer's lithium stopping at 11 hours and 38 minutes, 2 hours less than our top alkaline performers. But our battery specialist explains that's because the battery's made to put out peak performance and nothing less.
A lithium cell has a flat voltage delivery, where basically it keeps going like this and like this, until it gets to the end of its capacity, and then it's a cliff, and it basically just drops and stops dead, right? Whereas an alkaline, or a carbon zinc cell, is more of a curve, and it'll do the same thing, but it curves off like that.
This is handy to keep in mind when wanting a certain sound from an amp or brightness from a torch.
So a lithium battery is going to make sure your torch is brighter for longer, okay? It's going to stay much, much brighter for a longer period of time. Whereas an alkaline cell, you're going to get good performance, it's going to be great, but it will taper off and get dimmer and dimmer and dimmer.
So to recap, the Energizer Max Alkaline wins the award for keeping our train going the longest, Panasonic a close second, and Energizer Ultimate Lithium in third. But before you buy, it's worth looking at how much battery you're getting for your buck. We looked at the price we paid versus the time the batteries ran for, which gave a whole new set of results. Philips Alkaline was the cheapest 4-pack by far, at $2.24, even cheaper than the carbon zincs. So, when you consider it ran for 10 hours and 35 minutes, we were getting almost 5 hours of power for a single dollar. None of the others came near that, ranging from 1 hour to 1.5 hours. And the Energizer Lithium comes out the worst in this ranking, only giving us 24 minutes for every dollar we spent on the batteries. So, before you power up your summer, get the right battery for the job.